Brandy and cognac. The history of brandy, cognac. The term brandy is a corruption of the Dutch term brandywijn or burnt wine. The term burnt refers to the fact that the wine had been distilled. Dutch merchants buy wine from the Champagne and Bordeaux area and ship them to the Netherlands. But they soon had to realize that wine suffers from transportation, so the Dutch started to distill the wine and call it brandewijn. In the hot, humid holds of ships, new wine would quickly turn to vinegar. The bacterium that converts alcohol into vinegar, Acetobacter acetate, cannot tolerate alcohol levels higher than 20%. That's the reason that wine intended for long shipments would be fortified. That practice eventually gave rise to wines like port, sherry and Madeira. But distilling the wine was only a means for transportation, in order for them to be able to transport more. For consumption back in the Netherlands, they would add water again. The first reference to eau de vie du cognac dates from 1517. It's likely that distillation arrived at some point between the mid-14th century and the 15th century. The first stills were likely very small, operated by individual winemakers and, like the Gascon brethren in Armagnac, relied on a single distillation. Distilling wine that could not be shipped or sold domestically was a way of preserving the caloric and economic value of the wine. In addition, alcohol was in high demand, both for its medicinal uses and to fortify wines before long sea villages. Distilling wine into alcohol was profitable and a way for winemakers to supplement their income. Lewis Roberts mentions in 1638 a wine called Rochel or Cognaracki. Even more, in 1678 Cognac brandy is mentioned in the London Gazette. 12th century, wine merchants test the double distillation, the eau de vie is distilled twice. Originally, the double distillation process was done because of lower transport costs, as it led to less quantity and volume. This meant more space on the ships. In addition, the wine tax being levied on brandy was based on volume. So a more concentrated brandy would pay less tax. Jean Martel founds Martel Cognac in 1715. His family comes from the island of Jersey. Paul Emily Remy Martin and his father Jean Guy found in 1724 Cognac Remy Martin. In the French suburb of Bercy in 1809, Emmanuel Courvoisier started a wine and spirit company with Louis Gallois. A catastrophe, however, was just around the corner. Starting in the mid-19th century, European wine growers were struck by two successive plagues of grape disease that originated in the United States, powdery mildew and downy mildew. Then, in 1870, they were joined by a third deadly scourge, Phylloxera. One such pest was the Phylloxera aphid, Phylloxera vestatrix. The vine louse, as it was called, fed on the roots of grape plants, cutting off the supply of nutrients and water, creating openings that could be infected by fungi and bacteria. European grape varieties, unlike native US grapes, had no defense. Over three decades, roughly 80% of Europe's vineyards were destroyed. In the Charente by 1893, the area under grape cultivation was around 100,000 acres, a reduction of 86%. Another grape variety, Ugni Blanc, had been growing in popularity because of its natural resistance to downy mildew and powdery mildew, as well as its high yields. It took readily to the American rootstock. When Cognac's vineyards were replanted, they were done so primarily with Ugni Blanc. Fol Blanche disappeared. Today, 98% of the grapes grown for cognac production are Ugni Blanc. The lack of supply also spurred widespread counterfeiting. In response, in 1909, the French government delineated, by official decree, the boundaries that marked the region where cognac could be produced. For a brandy to be called cognac, it had to be distilled within the defined region, although it didn't need to be aged there. Brandy could still be produced outside the region, but it couldn't carry the cognac designation. Nowadays we have different types of cognac brandy. Armenian brandy has been produced since the 1887 and comes from the Ararat Plain in the southern part of Armenia. Bottles on the market are aged anywhere from 3 to 20 years. Armagnac is made from grapes of the Armagnac region in the southwest of France, Gers, Lond and Lot-et-Garonne. Armagnac was the first distilled spirit in France. Its usage was first mentioned in 1310 by Vital Dufour in a book of medicine recipes. Armagnacs have a specificity, they offer vintage qualities. Cyprus brandy is a variety of brandy made on the Mediterranean island of Cyprus. The production of brandy on Cyprus began in 1871 by E.T.K.O., the oldest surviving distiller on the island. Cyprus brandy is typically produced by double distillation of Exonisteri-based white wines with aging in oak barrels. Greek brandy is distilled from muscat wine. And the well-known brandy is Metaxa, is a Greek amber spirit created by Spyros Metaxa in 1888. Its taste comes from the combination of muscat wines from the island of Samos, aged wine distillates, and Mediterranean botanicals. Brandy de Jerez is a Spanish brandy which is made, as its name suggests, in the Jerez area of the Spanish region of Andalusia. To be more precise, it is produced in the Sherry Triangle, which is defined by the towns of Jerez de la Frontera, Sanlúcar de Barrameda and El Puerto de Santa María. Spanish brandy is sold as a drink in its own right, but is also used as an ingredient in the production of some sherries. In Moldova and Romania, grape brandy is colloquially called cognac, but is officially named Divin in Moldova and Vinars in Romania. After a double distillation, the beverage is usually aged in oak barrels and labeled according to its age, VS, minimum 3 years old, VSOP, minimum 5 years old, XO, minimum 7 years old, XXO, minimum 20 years old. Kizlia brandy is produced according to the classic cognac technology and is one of the most popular beverages in Russia. Kizlia was first produced in 1885 at the Kizlia brandy factory according to a recipe brought from France. Pisco is a strong, colorless to amber-colored brandy produced in specific regions of Peru and Chile. The name Pisco derives from the Peruvian port of the same name. Pisco is still made in Peru and Chile, but the right to produce and market it is subject to disputes between both countries. South African brandies are, by law, made almost exactly as cognac, using a double distillation process in copper pot stills followed by aging in oak barrels for a minimum of 3 years. Because of this, South African brandies are of very high quality. Italian Stravecchio has been produced since the 1700s in the north of Italy, especially in Emilia-Romagna and Veneto, using grapes popular in winemaking such as Sangiovese and Grignolino. The production of cognac brandy. The ideal grapes for distilling cognac are Colombard and Saint-Emilion. Blanche, Folduirancarn, Monfils, and Sauvignon are also used. The grapes are harvested in the winter when they are fruity and have the potential to produce juice that is 8-9% alcohol. Grapes with less than 8% alcohol are too pale to produce the desired aroma, those with more than 9% possess an inadequate concentration. The grapes are pressed and the juice is allowed to ferment naturally. No sugar or sulfur dioxide is added. First distillation: as soon as the wine has fermented, it is poured into pot stills enclosed in brick kilns. The kilns are heated to a temperature range between 78.3 degrees Celsius and 100 degrees Celsius until the alcohol vaporizes and separates from the rest of the liquid. The liquid, called brulis, is reduced one-third from the original amount and measures about 30% alcohol by volume. Second distillation: the brulis is heated a second time in a process known as bon chauffe. The remaining liquid is the clear eau de vie. It has been reduced by an additional one-third and is 70% alcohol by volume. This significant reduction in volume means that the distillation of cognac is a costly operation. It takes 9 liters of wine to make 1 liter of cognac. The amount of spirit that is lost to vaporization, known as the angel's share, can equal more than 20 million bottles annually. The eau de vie is piped into oak casks. The casks are housed in large damp warehouses, or cooperages. The vintage, CRU, and date are marked on each cask with chalk. Generally speaking, the brandy is first stored in newer casks for periods between 1 and 2 years. The amount of time is dependent on the level of tannin that is desired. Tannin is strongest in new oak, so the brandy must possess enough character to absorb large amounts of tannin. Aging and blending. The brandy is progressively moved into older casks, once again dependent on the finished product desired. Most of the tasting is done by the nose, very little cognac is actually orally tasted. Cognacs over varying vintages and from different crusts are blended to create the quality desired. This blending occurs over a minimum of 1 year with samples taken annually. Representative samples of each blending are kept for at least a decade. Each cognac house has a house style that is consistent year after year. Often this style is passed down from family member to family member as a memory of taste and aroma. Bottling the bottles in which cognac is packaged are a source of great pride to each company. Many of the bottles are handcrafted of crystal. They are often sealed with wax and draped with satin ornaments. Thank you for watching, don't forget to hit the like button and share it.